morning, everyone. Welcome back to my channel. Natalia here with you as always. And we have today part number two video review from DIY Choose. We did diamond painting. I think it was like seven, if I'm not mistaken, diamond paintings. If you missed the video, I will link it up for you. And today we will do unboxing actually on my desk by the window with some extra lights with my magnifier, because it's raining, it's very dark outside, and hopefully this will be enough light for you. So there is a new product at DIY Choose, and lovely owner, thank you so very much. She always tell me when it's something new arrived, so I can't review for you. So I choose, there's some tools, new tools, which some of them we already did review, but this one a little bit just a different color. And let's get started. So we have a tools, let's start with tools first, and then we check the other product as well. I will zoom a little bit close, hopefully for the better light. Now, so we do have in here tools, those beautiful metal tools for diamond painting, multi-placer, and they were kind enough to send me the whole thing. Okay, I don't know. Oh yes, it is sticker in here, and I'm trying to open there. This should help. Now, I have to say, my first video review when I did, and I will show you the, this is the colors that we have. We have them in silver, we have them in rose gold, which is not all of them in here, some of them already on my diamond painting pans sitting. And this one, you can see that this is a gold one. Maybe we can see this way better colors. You can see the difference between these two golds, so rose gold and actual gold. Now, I did try to work with this too, and I wasn't really impressed because I was working with the square diamonds. Now, after camera, I did try to diamond paint with round diamonds, and I have to say that for the round diamonds, these tools work much better, much better. And in here we should have what, 10 or how many? There is a extra rings in here that go right in these two points in here, just in case your drill pin not like a little bit not tight enough, so those rings gonna help. Not all of them, I have to say, fit into my when I try this one, not all of them fit in those fancy bulky drill pin. And for some of them, for example, in this pink tools, well, I put one, what is it, triplacer of this rose gold in here. But it's not very tight, but it's still kind of not as bad. But it's not very, very sturdy. And we can try to see, well, I can just remove this one and we can try with you how this pen will work. And at the same time, I want to see those that concerning me. First was this, yeah, also see the same thing. It's a very, very thin hole in here, so the wax barely go inside, and it's very hard to clean later if you have to. It's kind of basically not kind of possible to dig in from inside. So I still think they should a little bit fix. I did point it out to the factory to did a little bit of changing they promised me to do. And I see in here they accidentally put me two of the same tips. This is the one placer. But if we compare one placer, oh no, hold on, this is the square and this is round. Okay, so they are different. You can see the one square and one round. And you can tell that this one that is round has a much bigger hole. Now, if we compare these two together for the round hole, right? You can see how much smaller. It's almost like barely, okay, I need the light. very, very tiny hole. And if we compare this one, like a regular one, it's much bigger. So yes, this one will work better than this one. So we have in here a pointy, one placer, square and one placer. Where did they? I just, okay, here. Okay, and then we have two placer, three placer, four placer, this one, five placer, six placer, seven placer, eight, nine, ten, and straightener. Now, from all these tools, the straightener is my favorite. It really, really good work on diamond painting to straighten up your diamonds, because it's very sturdy, so it's better than plastic. I feel like we have not enough light, I don't know. I do really like this one, and I do work with some of them multi-placers, but with the round diamonds. With round diamonds, they work much better, so I would recommend for you to order if you like. But for the square, it's not much of the grab in the square diamonds, and that's what my concern was about. But they are gorgeous. They are really, really gorgeous. I love them a lot. And let's just test to have this will work on this one. Oh, this one is going pretty good. It's actually holding all right. It's coming out easy, but it's not like, you know, it's not gonna fall out of your pen. How about straightener? Because some of them like feels like more tight, the other one more, or maybe it depends on a pen. Looks good, looks good. So we will test with you more. I will put back in here my pink oil, actually, not the pink one. I will insert in here one of this new pen. I tried before diamond painting too. It's so strange to me. It's so kind of weird because never have before two placer. So maybe I will put in here two placer for now. And next time we do diamond paint, because some of you pick a beautiful Christmas diamond painting from my last video unboxing and you want me to work on it. So maybe we will use some of this multi-placer and try, because as I say, on round diamonds, they do look like work a little bit better. But this pointy I kind of like to use in my videos, not pointy, but this bandy. I just need them to have this hole bigger, because this bend like any hole in here. Okay, so this is the one that I wanted to show you. If you like to order, you can definitely order in this three different colors. They all have in this store. Now, the other tool that we will look today, let me put this on side in here so we don't spill accidentally. The other new item that they have, this cute little vacuum. It looks like I need a cut in here. Okay, now there's a probably will need a battery that I'm not convinced at this moment I have a battery, or do I? What kind of battery we need in here? Let's see. Oh, there's some extra tool in here. I see they have is it three colors? I know they have pink, the steel, and I think there is one more color. And I see that has an extra tool that I did not have before. And how does this tool work? Is it like this? Okay, I don't know. I don't know yet what this piece for. Or this is a little vacuum? It is, wow. Does it have like a lock device? No, it doesn't have a lock device, but it's really sturdy, go inside, so it's not gonna come out. So if you have an area, there's like, you know, sometimes you spill on the table, you have to like, you know, push your diamonds all together, and then you have like a mini vacuum nozzle. Oh, this is neat. This is totally different. This is totally different. We have a power button in here. Of course, we don't have a battery right now. Let's see. looks like, is this is the, okay, I'm trying to figure out where is opening. Okay, sorry about that. I had to stop video because I wanted to see if I have a battery at home. Actually, I did found battery, so I opened which one we need. We need two AA battery, and well, yes, I think it's AA. So we do have an instruction in here that show you how to open, which one to twist, and to open this device in here. There is a button in here on the front, so when you push this down, you can open this lid. So we will install battery right now and see if this work. So obviously in here, excuse me, we can see that it has a pink and green. So maybe it's only these two colors, but they are gorgeous. The one I have before I show you, I have this cutie, and I think DIY Choose also have this little guy. Look how cute. I think I still have a battery in here. Let's check. Yeah, it's working and I love it. And I thought, if you don't like kind of kiddish looking, cartoonish looking, a little tiny vacuum, this looks really kind of classy looking, and I love the color, and I actually like this, you know, extra tool in here. So let's, okay, I'm totally opening battery, not right. There's supposed to be like an opening in here, see? Live and learn. All right, now I see. We're gonna get a battery in here. We need two battery, AA, and we will see if this vacuum actually work. There. I'm not sure if it's button on right now. Oh, okay. Because okay. This is the button. All right, so obviously it's working. So I will close this lid right now. All you have to do, line up right up there, and just push it back into here button, and you just snap back. Now to open your bottom in here where you have your debris where you're picking it, you just hold this in your hand and turn it. And you have your piece open, so that's where all your diamonds will be arranged in here after you clean them. And little tiny brush, if you have to clean sometimes with stuff that we pick in, it could be debris of your puppy fur, cat fur, some fibers from the floor dust. So this is obviously a good tool to clean. And I just love this little addition, because the other one, my vacuum, doesn't have that. So now we're just going to line up back in here, and there's some ridges in here and the other side that we have to line up them perfectly to close this vacuum. And I think we are done. Yeah, looks like it's locked. Okay, so push of the button and we have our vacuum going. There, wonderful, wonderful. And I like this little nozzle in here. This is really neat. So if you are looking to buy something like this, this is really big help. If you like to spill diamonds a lot, this will help you. This will help you. And I just love the color and design. Very sleek design, very classy looking. Well, yes, and we have good instruction in here that finally they did, not just only in Chinese language, but also they translate everything for in English. And I didn't know they have this instruction first in the box. So I see, let's actually show you the nozzle going back in here. But we figure out that before I look on the instruction. All right, so now we have another new product with you to review, and that is in here we have three beaded stitching. Now you know how much I like beaded stitching, and I did ask them that we want something that is like a canvas beaten stitch, and it's like cross stitch but in beads. So far they all just bring in this kind of like a 3D project, but I give them hint what you like, what we want to see, and they promise me they will do their best to try to bring what we need to have and what we like to have. So hopefully in the future we will have a little bit more product in beaded stitching. So let me just pull out, because this one is really reflecting on the slide that I have right now in here. Now this is kind of like a wallet type, and it's a stitching on plastic. I did stitch before on plastic in a cross stitch with the threads and with the beads. I think this is going to be my first one stitching on a plastic. Yeah, definitely I stitch only in threads. So this one with the beads, let's see what we have in here. Oh, this looks bigger than I thought. Wow, how many pieces? Wow, oh my god, look at that. They have inserts as well, so it's everything in here, not just the beads and cover. So this is your wallet. You see, this is what we're going to create, your business cards, credit cards, wallet. So this is going to be our kind of book to open. Then we put this inserts. It's, I have to say, it's very big. It's very big. Is there any other instruction here? We will see. Maybe we will have some extra, or this is supposed to be folded. Or look at that, even we can do like this from one piece, and you can have another one more. This would be just perfect enough, just one. Wow, so you can stitch two actually. Is it, is this is for two? So how many pages in here? So this one inserts. Oh, okay, I think I know. Because this one have to insert somewhere. So when you put this on the side, maybe like this. Okay, we have to check. We have to check, because we have another piece. And this is plastic. The very, very, very soft plastic. Let me zoom and show you. This is very flexible, almost like a fabric, but this is a plastic that it... Oh my goodness. Okay, I feel dummy right now. I did not see the print in here. Look at that. Like, you cannot see the print. Well, now I can see through the camera, but I did not see this. So that's it. That's, you have your pieces right in here. So now I know. We have to stitch, probably cut in half or cut out these pieces, because it will be stitches in here. So then you have to kind of plastic to cover, so it's not very visible. Okay, what else in here? Okay, so we have a pattern in here as well. This is our kind of like a closure, like a lock, this piece. Where is it showing you? Right, like right in here. That's the one, the lock, go from the back to the front to close. But it's kind of like a two pieces in here, so maybe you can stitch two of them in here. And then how many colors? Six colors, and number four something, like maybe outline and maybe back stitching, because I don't really understand what this means. Maybe like a back stitching. Okay, so then we have some special stitching outline in like right in here. Oh, I can't believe, my friends, how dark this is. And I thought by the window will be better. So we have how many of these pages we have in here? Looks like a lot. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I have somewhere in here used up card. Used up my card that I'm using on shopping online. Let's see if this will fit in here. Oh yeah, see, it's fit perfectly. Okay, it's fork. So what did I say, how much is here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then you would have 5 more on this side. I think maybe we are too close. So 10 credit cards you can put in here, or gift cards, whatever it is. And then this is like a perfect fit right in here. So this could be, or two, you can create two of them, or just one. I still have to figure out how this work and why these pieces are so big. Because what I see in here is like, there's a two pieces in here. Here's the one wallet, and there's something else in here. So that's kind of questionable. I have to check. Okay, there's a more on the back that I did not pay attention. What's in here? Well, of course, in here, everything in Chinese. And that's their problem with not having translation. Well, I guess those are extra pieces of fabric, because if you look in here, we have this closure in here. So obviously we need to cut little piece in here to cover that design, this design on the other side, so we don't see threads coming through, right? So it's gonna be like nice and neat, clean closure when we're done. Here is the template, how it looks like before it's done. This dark spot in here, that's obviously where we're gonna put our book in here. And what else? There's the measurements where you're supposed to put this closure. You see how much you have to go over. And this is something else in here that I have no idea for now how this will work. But I guess we will figure out together with you. Now we have lots of canvas in here. Good chunk of canvas. This canvas usually is expensive. Because this soft canvas more cost than the one that like that we stitch hard plastic building a house. This one is more expensive, but I wish they would bring like a big sheet, like a standard big sheets, so we can purchase and design something that we like. In here I see, oh, there's actually marking in here on the canvas. In here, little dot, and right in here, where your closure is supposed to be stitched to it. And in here, the other button that's supposed to be a closure. So we should have some kind of button or maybe magnet in here. Let's see what else we have in here. Beautiful colors of threads. Oh yeah, I can see some button in here. Needles just on the loose in here, or it's in a little, no, just in a loose. Okay, that's a little bit dangerous, I would say. They should put needles into the Ziploc bag. They should never ever leave a needles unattended just like that, because they can slip away from these bags. And this is big mistake. I hope they listen to me and they fix this little trouble, because it can fall out while you're carrying this package around your house, because obviously this zip tight not going to hold it very well. So we have a two of very, very super thin needles. It's very, very, very tiny. And then we have one needle, kind of normal, like a 14 count needle. I like this needle. Let me zoom. Okay, I need to get some kind of like a magnet in here. Just a minute. This is a little bit dangerous with those needles like this without having a magnet. So I will bring my... Actually, I have this little cute cushion. Right there, we are going to put needles right in here. Yeah, they also have this at the store if you wanna order. What I like about this needle, it's not a sharp needle. well, if you push very, very hard, yeah, you can injure yourself, but it's basically like medium spiky, and mostly kind of it's going to be smooth go through the canvas, but not very, very sharp, and will be very comfortable needle to stitch on your regular cross stitch as well. Let's see if we can see a little bit more close. You see this little tip in here? It's not very, very sharp, kind of like a medium sharpness, and I like that. And this too is just super, super thin needles, very thin for the beads, so the beads can go through. Okay, now we have this one button closure, just a plastic one. I was hoping to get like a metal one, but plastic I guess will work as well. How strong that is, I don't know. I will not try to open right now, it will be tricky with nails to open, but with the help of the tweezers you could probably open. It's a closed right now, two pieces together, so obviously it's working because it's closed and it's holding together nice. The beads colors in here, very pretty, very pretty. Look at this. Let me see them. Let me see them first. Yeah, some whole of them bigger, some smaller. The way they lay in here, I think you can see, but not horribly bad. They are a little bit different sizes, but not as bad. Of course, the real judgment will be when we will stitch something first, and then we will see how they will perform. Then we have this lighter blue color. No, not bad. The beads in here are not bad. I have to say it's actually very nice beads. So far what I see through the plastic, it looks pretty good. Looks pretty good. Not sure how much we can see the quality right now like this. And two, no, three color. Oh, this one is like transparent. This one is pretty. Can you see the transparency of it? Or maybe over the light color of my table you can see a little bit better. And then this beautiful silver line on the inside of this green. Nice and glowy color. And then another green transparent as well. Very pretty colors. So this three green will create for us beautiful shading, you know, from darker to lighter. I think it looks beautiful. And this two blue. And then also we have in here a big bag of black, because we need to, there's a lots of black in here, outlining everything, absolutely, also outlining on a outside in here, so there's lots of black, and this is the big bag, hopefully will be enough. This bead, let's see this bead, are they good, are they not? We will figure out when we will work on it. It looks good to me right now. Yeah, they, some of them have a hole bigger, some of them smaller, so maybe a little bit different sizes of the beads as well. But pretty much when I was stitching my little charms, they look good as a finished project. I don't know if I have this close to me right now to show you quickly. Let me see if I have like right in here somewhere. Oh, maybe not at this moment. No, it's not in here. I was gonna show you those charms that I did, but this bead's not bad. Now, as I mentioned, they have to have Ziploc bag to put needles in a Ziploc bags first, then put into this bag, because the way they are loose, it's a little bit dangerous. So I will put this later in a Ziploc bags. I have tons of those around here. Let's put our parts back into this baggie and we look with you the threads. Okay, they just tied up together like this. I wanna see how big length of them is, like a meter long or not. How many threads we have in here. Let's untangle a little bit. Okay. Yeah, so definitely it's like a meter long threads. I'm just trying to untangle them. Here's the beautiful colors. Of course, no DMC code. Do we have DMC code? No, we don't. Well, we probably have DMC code, but yeah, try to read it. Or maybe this is the names of the colors, but no DMC code, obviously. So there you have it. We have coordinating colors that go with those beads. Lots of black, three strands of black color, three of dark blue, and the other one of each. But nice and feel silky, those threads. Looks beautiful. I will even up this later because I don't like when they like this after level. They need to be all straight. Okay, so this was one of them. Let's see the other design. So basically we will have same concept of this beaded. Let's open this one first. It's kind of same thing. Now I can see the yes instruction on the back, but we just want to see designs. And this was kind of like our the best designs that I picked. The other one designs I didn't really care about, but I thought maybe some of you, if you are Irish, you probably will like this with clover leaf for the lock. It says good luck in here. Yeah, so definitely you can create two of those wallets because it feels like it's showing, unless it show you from one side and another, unless it's two separate. I have no idea. And here's our pattern in here. Again, we have this big chunk of double plastic folded on half and one is open. Oh, here is the one open that we need to design to stitch. And I'm actually really glad that they printed on a canvas instead of being counted stitch. So this will save you time and energy and will be so easy for you to just stitch, you know, on already printed canvas. And this one very simple, not much stitching at all. You will finish this very quick, like in one day, seriously. This is like one day project. That's it. We have same one book wallet. You can definitely can buy a few for Christmas right now. And now we're just going to see beads. It feels like the beads, exactly the same beads green in here that we have already up there. But again, the needles in here on the loose. So I have to be careful. Isn't that gorgeous? Colors of threads in here together. See, when I pull the threads, the needles coming out as well. Okay, we're gonna rescue this one as well. Give them home. One more needle. So with each kit you will have three needles, two thin and one is big one for the stitching. So we have as well in here this little plastic button. And I believe, let me just check with this design that we just opened with you. Just a minute. Because I think that these beads are exactly the same one. Yes, it is. It's the same color as this dark green, and those the other two colors of green, same one that we have in here. So they kind of like a same collection. Yeah, same thing. So we already know the quality of these beads. Well, we'll see when we stitch, but that's a pretty, very big bag of this color. And the threads in here, so pretty combination all together, the way they put together. I really like this combo. Yes, so this is another of your design. And then we have one more. So let me know if you want me to start on one, so we can figure out if this is one design or this is two wallets. I will be working on it to figure out how this work, all these big pieces, if this is going to be for two wallets or one. So we'll see. All right, this is pretty. This is pretty. And then we have one more that's probably, I say, my favorite probably. This is the most beautiful to me. You let me know which one favorite for you today. Now remember that we still have more cross stitch to review from DIY Choose, and our next video will be three cross stitch kits. So this one, let me show you the design first. It's the flowers, like rose. Not sure what kind of flowers this is, but I really like this design. I think it's pretty. Very pretty bright colors. So this was my favorite. And then we have the same double canvas in here. And then we have printed canvas right in here. There. That's nice. Kind of like a mirror image, you can tell. So when we fold like this, put closure stitch to it to lock it, and we have our wallet. So this one will be, I think you can stitch two of them. That's what's the purpose. I have no idea. And then we have same book for 10 pages. Let's see those bright juicy colors. Some different beads in here. We are going to find the needles first, because with pets in a house, it's a little bit dangerous, because I have no idea right now, or they all in here together with the threads. So when you receive this kind of kit, please watch for the needles first thing you will do. Okay, so I have in here my three needles. I will put them back into this. Yeah, see, like this needle didn't want to go in because it's not as sharp, but it's comfortable for stitching. Now look at this color. So obviously these two colors we already see with you in our previous designs. It's the same thing. Okay. And then here we have yellow. Let's see if I can bring you even more close to show you beads a little bit better. Okay, I think it's a little bit better this way. Those two greens that we saw already, one with silver on the inside, and this one is transparent. Also this one, is this, no, this one don't have a silver line. No, it looks like, yeah, no, I think it's a little bit silver lining, but not as, or maybe not, I cannot recognize. No, it doesn't have a silver lining. This one does. This one doesn't. And then we have gorgeous transparent. You can tell that they are silver kind of looking. That's a pretty. Oh, look at this one, red. I have in my stash this kind of red in my bead stash. Probably I have this orange as well. Oh, and this one, red one, very kind of similar, something that I wonder if that's the one that I'm stitching, beaded stitching. Very kind of feels similar color, but gorgeous. Look at this. Look at this combo. Isn't it beautiful? Yeah. I feel like this is like a or two colors. Oh no, maybe it depends how they lay in the back. Feels like it's two color, but I think because this one laying flat, whole up, and this one sideways looks darker. I think that's what it is. Because it feels like it's two colors on the inside. Unless they are mixed. I'm not sure at this point, till we open bags later on. And here's our beautiful threads. Very colorful, beautiful, beautiful combo. So it is going to be very bright, very cheery design. And check it out, what else they have up there in the beaded section, because they did bring a whole bunch of different designs, but most of them, like for the kids, for little tiny kids, something, lots of charms, some those gnomes and other creatures that I don't really like. I like flowers, something more girly looking, more adult looking. And this tree design was the best designs in the store, so that's why I picked them for you to see. And let me know, hold on just a minute, I will pull out the other one. Yeah, let me know which one you like the most. Or I should show you, not like this, I should show you designs like this one. Okay, so we will see this way. I'm gonna put this on the inside so we can mix nothing. Okay, so from this three designs, please let me know which one is your favorite. I would love to know your taste. Yes, as I say, if you Irish, you probably will choose this one because it's close to your heart. It's kind of represent who you are, and you can give this as a gift to somebody if you know somebody Irish. So this is definitely will be a beautiful present, even better if you create and then gift. Or if person crafty, they maybe can assemble by themselves, right? Well, thank you so much everyone for this video review. I think we have some amazing product in here. I really, really love this cute little vacuum in here as well. And so as the toolkit, like the way they look, it's a very beautiful look of them. We just have to more practice to see which one will work the best. But they do perform better on round diamonds, because round diamonds more pointy, except that like a square one more flat top, and that's why it's a little bit difficult to pick up the square diamonds, but it worked better for round. So try it. You can purchase one or two, or you can purchase the whole kit together. They are not expensive, and you can try it, see if you like it. You know, so many people, and it could be different opinion. My opinion is my opinion. Your opinion could be absolutely different, and I do appreciate your opinion. Please comment below. Subscribe if you wish to follow my channel and watch videos every single day. I love you all. You are my biggest supporters ever. I love you all so much. You keep me on my toe every single day. Even sometimes when I feel under the weather, I get up and record video, and you keep me busy and motivated, because without you, I would be probably falling sometimes in depression, who knows. You are my heroes in my heart, and I appreciate you so very much. Thank you for watching, and I will see you tomorrow.